Only one can get the gold, and it's going to go to none other than TSM.
Scope goes. Nagano needs to be careful. They have great angles on him. There's another shot. Shields, goodbye. This is dangerous territory now for these teams down low. Lazarus, they have this high ground position. And Dreadnought had mentioned this earlier when we checked in with him. High ground was going to be so important here. This hill, look how sharp this is. And now Postkill's going to go in for this fight, but he's going to go down. Kashera now with the R99. He's going to be out there, but it got to phase out because he took so much damage. Smithy J's going to go down, and it's all falling to pieces. The wheels on the wagon have fallen off, and Lazarus, they're going to be eliminated. What was looking like a great game for them, not going to happen. Here's Nagano, though. Nagano 1998, the only team in this competition that is unsigned, and they have these players pinned at the back of that wall, daring them to go after them, daring them to challenge. They have time to mess around with. Shots right through the cracks there. It's going to be AKU by himself needing to win this match for his team in a 124 pop. He smells blood. He's going to go in for it, and it's reps from TSM. He needs to get the shield battery up in time. R99 is going to go out. Bob and weave. Dive, dick, dump, dive, and dodge. Is he able to do it, though? R99 in play. What a shot from the wingman. Unbelievable. He's going for the snapshot of the longbow, but it ain't gonna happen. TSM gets the win.
Talk to me about what was going through your head at those last moments.
It was super stressful. I was getting hit all the time by those guys. We were telling Hal just to block for me so I could pop meds. He was blocking all the damage, so Hal was a big part of that. It was not really just a 1v2. Hal saved me right there.
You guys had a little bit of a rocky start for the first couple games. It wasn't as high of a finish as you guys were wanting. What changed in team communication or strategy coming into match four?
We were just rotating incorrectly. So we talked about it during the break and fixed our problems. Yeah, it should be a lot better from now on.
I've got reps from TSM. You guys are sitting in first place coming into today. There are six matches that stand between you and the gold medal. What's going through your head?
Right now, we're just trying to make sure we're consistent. We went over all the VODs. I talked about our problems yesterday. We had a few issues with losing a player early on. Hoping we can fix that today. Stay consistent. Keep that placement in mind. Placement's the most important. And go for the gold.
They have been unmatched this whole time. Maybe got peppered up a few times, but boy, oh boy, they have looked beautiful. Imperial Hal finds two in front of him. He's gonna have the R99 shredding through the shields. Here comes the EVA-8, and it is gonna do the job, clean up duty. What a rough engagement for T1 in that corner. Shot on wipes there, Abrilelli. What a wingman from that player. Again, continuing to connect for 43 damage, cracking the shields. And a Mastiff for his trouble. And Kashera connects, beautifully done, but Smithy J had to get pushed back from that. That was TSM on the push. Abrilelli is gonna make Postkill suffer for that. Kashera looking for the shot, but it's gonna slip away from Lazarus yet again. They had the prime positioning, but TSM simply had their number.
And here you can see just how powerful Abrilelli is. Out comes the Mastiff. There's no way you're gonna be able to deal with that one. 133 damage, one shot, no chance, absolutely shut out these electric fences. The defense comes in with the ordinance, but TSM, they don't look like they will be denied for too much longer. The Grim Reaper's coming for you, and there it is, the Mastiff around the corner, looking to finish it off. The humanity of the situation, they wanted to go for it. They could have waited it out, but TSM, they have no mercy.
And they are your first team to win two games here at the X Games. Bangalore has that passive that when she's taking fire, she can run away faster, which will allow her to disengage quicker. Reps spots the enemies there. Does manage to land a few shots onto some individuals. Another one around the corner. That's going to be Kyrie from Complexity. Moving in for another one is Abrilelli. Goodbye, Complexity. Patience. Also Reciprocity showing up in the feed. Reps finds one in front of him. The R301's going to go out, and they're going to wipe the floor there with Smithy J and Kashera. Goodbye. Bye. You are not going to be in this game much longer. Brilliant play there from them. TSM now on your screen. Imperial Hal, Abrilelli. There goes the push. And here's the L-Star. Hey, you said it was butt cheeks. Abrilelli has something else to tell you because Moose is going to feel the pain there. And then flying in. Oh no, there you go. The Mastiff now again. It goes out. He's stunned, and TSM, they're out of this one. The squad has been eliminated by T1, so the number one team in the lobby is out of the game, DDK.
Let's add it into the overall standings. Oh. Reciprocity is tied with TSM in the first place point collection. Now, we have some tie-breaking results. We have a method of doing this, but we also still have one game ahead where one of these two teams could potentially pull ahead.
It all boils down to this. We're wasting no time, folks. It's the final match here at X Games. Let's discuss what we saw there with the standings, DDK. So much to take away from that.
Oh, absolutely. There's three teams, of course, the top three teams. It's absolutely wide open between them. We saw how close it was. And it can come down to so many things, a mixture of placements, kills, but also, as you say, if Tempo Storm have an enormous game, they can maybe creep their way up into that top three. It is so open in this last game. This is what you want. And if there's a god, if there is someone up there listening, give us a great final circle for this one, because it's going to be crazy given how much intensity, how much pressure, how much there is on the line for so many of the teams still in the running.
Let's not forget, though, that TSM, the way that they've been playing, keeping themselves competitive through and through has been unbelievable to watch. The sheer fact that they managed to hold on to their lead all day long, despite the efforts of all these quality teams, is I'm so impressed and dare I say just proud of these guys for how they've been playing today.
I should say, Retzi gets out. Xenox is going to be right behind him. He's taking shots from the side. He has to dip out of there and slide down this hill as quickly as he can. Is this going to be the end of Sentinel's run? Xenox, he's going to get tagged, and he's going to go down. And that is leaving Retzi, the lone man standing. Finds one in front of him. He needs to reload his weaponry, but Sentinels are out of here.
TSM is still in. TSM, absolutely. TSM lurking around looking for that opportunity. We heard them say one of the things that is the strongest for them as a team that they identify with is good shot calling.
Reciprocity still in this game, but Reciprocity are losing players here. TSM are in this one, Dan.
And it looks like C9 have actually come onto the position of Fnatic, who were dug in also. So it looks like nobody's safe in this position. But TSM, they've worked themselves in. And there it goes, throwing his sail through the air. And Mimu's down. Imperial Howl with the frag, and there are huge problems now. Reciprocity, they're out of the action, but TSM still need to close things down. They can't afford to go down in this position, and TSM still just edging their way forward. You can see how incredibly methodical they are every time we tune into their position. They're not trying to take, you know, they're not trying to bully their way into spots that are super fortified, like where Fnatic have classically been. They just be working their way position by position, inch by inch, and now they find themselves here, and they just have a small amount of space to work with, but they look secure for the time being. Four squads left, and we still haven't seen Fnatic and TSM encounter one another. You can see Luminosity here trying to just find some safe haven to recover, to bandage themselves up after these fights that have been so difficult to deal with. And Fnatic, they're still sitting pretty with that elevation. And I don't think Luminosity are going to move for a while here. You can see TSM found some elevation of their own, but they actually need to find their way out of this position eventually. It's not the safest. And just coming in from below, nice stuff there. What a response. Athletico's Leon is going to go down, and Albralele is going to finish off Nokedi as well and say goodbye to the Aussies.
Yeah, Athletico were the fourth team in this battle. You got Fnatic, LG, they're squaring off against one another here. And then TSM inside of the house. Bullet, goodbye. Great effort there by the Aussies, by the OCE qualifiers.
TSM, they're going to feel confident. They're going to reassess their position. They know they have less pressure on their shoulders. They know that they may have done enough. I'm sure they've been doing the math before coming into this game. They knew what they had to do, and they are about to finish it all off. They just have to have one more good final finish.
And here we go. The ring is going down. This is where players are going to dance around on top of the zip line. And the Arc Stars are flying through, though. Shiny gets two down. He phases out. He won't be taking any damage here. He's inside the safe area. And Shiny, along with three members of Fnatic, still going to be in this game here. Right outside, and Fnatic get the last win. But it was against TSM, and hugs for the team because they know that they did enough to pick up the victory.
Well, congratulations to all three of you yet again. Team Reciprocity with the silver medal, but only one can get the gold, and it's going to go to none other than Team Solo Mid. I'm gonna come right in the middle here so I can hang out with all of you. First up, okay. It's like a perfect hip size for you too, isn't it?
Perfect.
All right, first on the end, you guys got the gold medal. You slayed out. At the beginning of today, you were tied for first for Apex Predator. What's it like now having such a fragging ability, but also walking away with the gold medal?
It feels amazing. Like, obviously, I can't frag without my teammates. You know, it's not a solo thing. So, you know, having to do both, it's great. It's just a team thing, you know.
You guys showed up here as one of the favorites to win. The shot calling and the listen-ins for the comms was unbelievable, and you walk away with a gold medal. What's it like being able to bring that back home?
It's the best feeling in the world. This is a dream come true, honestly.
Reps, we sat down before the matches when you flew in Wednesday, Thursday. I said, how are you feeling? You said, we're feeling pretty good. And then last night and this morning, I said, what are you going to do? And you said, nothing but first is what I want. You walk away with first. You walk away with gold. No glitz, no glamour. How do you feel?
No words. It feels unreal. I'm so happy. I don't know. I'm so freaking happy.
You are a team that have been together for a while. You are representing not only yourselves and the skills that you have, but you're representing TSM. You have this jersey. You will be representing them in Poland as the winners of the first professional tournament. What are you going to do now to look forward to Poland?
That just gave me goosebumps, dude. I don't know. I'm hoping we can get a lot of practice in, keep improving, and go for the first place there too.
Final question. Anything you have to say to any of the fans out there, any family, anyone that's been supporting TSM through and through since day one in Apex Legends?
Thank you so much to all my fans, all of House fans, all of Albert Lely's fans. We love you guys so much. Thank you so much to TSM for giving us the opportunity to come out here and win for them. Thank you so much to my parents for believing in me that I could do this, and it paid off.